Good evening. Please stay with us. That was the plea from a desperate government today to a city and a state fatigued by lockdown and dismayed by frustratingly high COVID numbers. Cases have dipped slightly with 415 new infections. Even tougher stay-at-home restrictions come into force tonight. But the Premier has now admitted eliminating Delta completely is near impossible.
In New South Wales, our world seems to be getting smaller by the day, and if we needed a reason, an especially blunt Dr. Kerry Chant laid out why.
I can't stress enough the seriousness of the current situation and my grave concerns that these case numbers will continue to escalate.
There were 415 new locally acquired cases in the 24 hours to 8pm. 66 were active in the community for at least part of their infectious period. 273 are still being investigated. Sadly, there were four more deaths, three women who were aged in their 50s, 70s and 80s, and a man in his 80s. 381 people are in hospital, 62 in ICU, 19 are aged between 20 and 50, 43 above 50. 24 people are on ventilators. Among those in hospital, a 15-year-old boy admitted with pneumococcal meningitis but also positive for COVID-19. He is gravely ill. The decision to shut down the state came yesterday after a midday briefing from health officials to the crisis cabinet.
Yesterday was an absolute wake-up call. We don't want to go down the path of all these other places overseas where they have literally thousands and thousands and thousands of cases a day. That's what Delta is doing to communities that have much higher vaccination rates than we do.
The answer, get vaccinated and follow tougher public health orders.
We can't afford to have infectious people in the community without us knowing about it.
We're still finding that people are visiting each other and we're still finding that workplace transmissions are set off.
Delta doesn't leave any room for error. Even a handful of people doing the wrong thing creates absolute havoc.
You seem to be suggesting that our fate now lies in the hands of people who don't care or won't comply with the health order. That may not change, ever.
That's why we're asking people to take notice.
A message echoed by the Prime Minister.
Stay at home. Stay at home. Only leave when you absolutely have to. There's no need to be out for hours and hours and hours a day.
But that message is still not getting through. This was Manly today, and while exercise may be allowed, the crowds would be a concern. Those sitting and not moving were moved on by police. Sunbakers on beaches in our east were also told to leave, a sign compliance enforcement is increasing. By comparison, in Western Sydney, parks were deserted. Streets in hotspots such as Auburn, Guildford, Blacktown and Maryong almost deserted. Here, at least, it seems the gravity of the situation is understood, and with good reason. Blacktown had the most cases in the past 24 hours, 84, followed by Canterbury-Bankstown with 74, Cumberland with 55, Penrith 40, Liverpool 23, Parramatta 16, Fairfield and Bayside with 14 each, Georges River 10, Campbelltown 7 and Strathfield 5. Growing case numbers in Western New South Wales are of particular concern, 19 in Dubbo, cases in Walgett, exposures in Bourke. In Sydney's West, three schools have been shut down for cleaning after members of those school communities tested positive. A person performing COVID tests at Central Station has also tested positive after working between August 4th and 13th. Hundreds of transport staff are now in isolation, forcing dozens of regional and interstate services to be cancelled. It's clear reaching Freedom Day will rely on increasing vaccination rates, but
there is no silver bullet, and vaccination is not a silver bullet. It's a tool. And vaccination alone will not get us out of this situation.
Don't assume because you've had a jab that you're safe. It takes at least 2 to 3 weeks for the impact of that jab to take effect. And even when you're vaccinated, it doesn't mean you can't get it or you can't pass it on, but certainly it keeps people out of hospital.
And that means, Dr. Chan says, that we each have a choice to make.
Do not take risks. Protect your loved ones and just hold with us with an intensity. Over the upcoming 2 to 3 weeks, it's a very, very bad picture if we don't make that choice together.
Sobering advice at an ever more sobering time. Eddie Meyer, Nine News.
In just a matter of hours, Sydney's lockdown will get even stricter. Nine's Laura Tunstall joins me from Kirribilli. Laura, take us through the new restrictions.
Well, Pete, these new restrictions are about further limiting the movement of Sydneysiders. From midnight, you must stay within your own local government area or within 5 kilometres of your home. Now, that 5 kilometre radius is designed for people who live closer to shops or essential services that are in a neighbouring LGA. However, if you live in one of the 12 declared areas of Sydney, you must stay there. Fines are also increasing for people who do the wrong thing, and tonight police will launch Operation Stay at Home with greater powers to ensure compliance.
A clifftop party in Clovelly pushing police over the edge. 31 teenagers fined, the gathering flying in the face of Operation Stay at Home just hours after the crackdown was announced.
Well, I think there's a rave going on, a bunch of people having a party down there. Which they're not allowed to because of lockdown restrictions.
Overnight in Parramatta, officers found themselves in a standoff with a COVID-positive family.
I need you to comply with this. Okay, if you're not going to comply with it, I'm going to arrest you.
A man barricading himself in his home with his pregnant wife and 2 young daughters.
Just spoke to my lawyer. My lawyer said, don't let them in, barricade the door.
They were eventually removed and taken to hotel quarantine. The chief health officer today defending powers that allow police to pull people from their homes if deemed a risk to public health.
I can just be confident that our public health doctors do not issue Section 62s for no reason.
We also need to make sure that we take every measure we can to ensure people are doing the right thing, but there is a policy in place which is asking people to go into that special accommodation.
529 penalty infringement notices were issued overnight, a further 29 people charged. Today at Manly Wharf, the famous ferry terminal turned police checkpoint, an increased compliance presence that will only ramp up from midnight.
1,400 highway patrol officers will be out and about with their specialist equipment, patrolling back roads, setting up roadblocks, so there is simply nowhere for you to go if you want to breach public health orders.
Operation Stay at Home will have a key focus on mobility. Police have enlisted the help of nearly 1,000 ADF personnel to enforce tough new measures, including a 5 kilometre limit for shopping and exercise. Anyone caught breaking these rules could face a fine of up to $5,000.
We need 100% of people to stay at home and comply with the orders. Not 90%, 100%.
An overt operation hoping to finally bring case numbers down. James Wilson, Nine News.
To news just in, Mudgee High School will be closed for cleaning tomorrow due to a positive COVID case. That's the latest in a string of regional schools exposed to the virus, a rising number of children among the daily infections.
Just 11 years old, Latoya Smith has COVID.
I felt pretty scared because I didn't know when I got the COVID, so I might have put people in danger from it.
Sick and already in isolation for a week, it's taking a toll on the Dubbo family.
People with no family around or friends around, it's hard.
The Smiths case highlighting the different challenges of a COVID outbreak between the city and the bush. They first got tested last Sunday.
We didn't get our result till Friday, so that was a long wait.
Tonight, 63 people across western New South Wales are infected with the Delta strain. Most are Aboriginal or children. This Mudgee petrol station, one of 2 more exposure sites identified late last night. A COVID-positive staff member working while infectious for 10 days.
This is a situation that will continue to grow.
Dubbo Zoo's accommodation today converted into the region's first Medi hotel, while communities as far west as Bourke now on high alert.
Through any crisis, normally our community response and our family response is that we gather together, but right now we've got to do this in a very different way.
On the Central Coast, 2 new cases, both linked to a school. Numbers are settling in the Hunter region.
The Hunter New England, of course, we're seeing stabilisation, but still 9 cases and we're focused on Maitland.
Like thousands of regional students, Latoya will start homeschooling tomorrow. But perhaps we can all learn something from her.
Stay indoors because you never know if you might catch it or spread it to someone else.
Dimity Clancy, Nine News.
For weeks, the Premier has been begging for more Pfizer, and tonight it's finally on the way. 1 million extra doses en route to Australia. It comes as our state hit a major vaccination milestone, the rollout well and truly ramping up.
It's empty now, but in a matter of hours, the doors will open to the biggest vaccination hub in the state. The Qdos Bank Arena transformed on a day when the Prime Minister announced there's a plane load of precious cargo on its way.
There's more than 1 million doses of hope on its way.
1 million doses of Pfizer direct from Poland. Half of them are bound for New South Wales. The first plane load will arrive tonight.
530,000 of these doses will be prioritised for express delivery to the 12 city local government areas where the COVID-19 outbreak continues to grow.
Please know we'll be putting that to very good use. We'll be targeting 16 to 39-year-olds in those local government areas of concern.
And the bookings are open now. 49,000 Pfizer shots available in the next week alone. A vaccination ramp-up for those in the most COVID-stricken suburbs.
They are the ones that are mobile because of their work. They are the ones who cross three generations, and they are the ones who are part of the 70% of cases that we're currently experiencing in those most problem areas.
It's been conceded time and again that vaccination is our only way out. Today, a glimmer of hope. We hit a milestone.
On a very positive note, New South Wales hit 5 million jabs. 50% of our population has received their first dose.
At the Olympic Park vaccination hub, construction workers came by the thousands. Lines wrapping around the block on a day dubbed Tradie Sunday.
Just get the vaccine and get it over with.
It's brilliant. I couldn't believe how good the system was, yeah. 10 out of 10.
Everyone is excited to get this ones.
If I don't get the Pfizer today, I'll just get the AstraZeneca. And rather do your bit, you know what I mean? And once it's over, it's over.
If you are a construction worker, keep your white card and driving licence ready, please.
And today is our big construction worker and tradie day, so we're hoping that at least 10,000 people will get vaccinated today, specifically in the construction and tradie occupations.
The drive came amid new rules for those in the construction industry, requiring workers in declared hot zones to have at least one dose of the vaccine before they can return to work. So tradies this week, it was food providers last Sunday. Now the hospitality industry wants a slice of the vaccination pie.
What we'd like to see is a super Sunday where we get as many hospitality workers with their responsible service of alcohol cards getting out to a vaccination centre and getting the jab.
With workers inoculated, the hope is pubs, bars, clubs, restaurants and cafes can begin to come back to life.
We're all in this together, and I think it's about just getting everyone that we can vaccinated, especially hospitality staff and frontline staff.
At the Royal Albert Hotel in Surry Hills, it's been a long lockdown. Publican Michael Bain is waiting for the day he can welcome patrons back through the door.
It's the patron smile, and I think the patrons want to get back into the pubs, and we'd love to see them back in having a schooner.
The government does need a roadmap, so hospitality businesses have some hope.
Stacked up chairs and tables and not a soul in sight. When you look around at restaurants, it's hard to see the road ahead. But industry groups are hopeful that outdoor dining for vaccinated patrons could be one answer to opening up.
They did it in New York, they opened the streets and kind of started back there. I think the hospitality industry would be happy with that as a start.
But if you want to go into a hotel, that should be the case that you've been vaccinated.
Lauren Tomasi, Nine News.
Service New South Wales has now received more than 242,000 applications for help from businesses struggling during the COVID lockdown. Yesterday alone, almost 3,000 applications were received and $65 million worth of assistance was approved. Since applications opened on July 19, more than 66,000 are still waiting to be processed, tying up $773 million in help.